Hey everyone, I hope you're having an amazing day. My name is Dave Bashinsky. I wanted to show you how I built this stone arch. As a skateboarder, I'm always trying to build something or improvise something to be skated. So this always inspired me to, you know, build at some point. I've never worked with stone, and I'm going to show you guys the process. And it took 2 months to complete, and this was all built with no mortar. So let's do this. We just made our flat line. We did 24 inches going this way, 24 inches going this way, mark the center. Now we're gonna cut. We set this rock up so it's 16 inches every cut, and we're gonna go all the way around this. So we just got the top on. We got three studs in the back, put two in the middle, one in the end, and then we went around and we leveled them out. It was really hard to get this top end to line up with the back, so we put this, kind of rigged it up, pushed it forward, and now we're gonna fill it in with the rest of the studs. So all the rocks are sorted. I'm gonna take these two pieces and make two 45 degree cuts and use this as a back support for that. This has been the game changer. So all these sides, try to get them as flush as I could. And I got these giant slabs underneath, so basically this will keep it angled up. I'll have these a little bigger that give some support. Start stacking these up. So I wrote down some tips and tricks, something that I would want to know if I wanted to build this. Think about location. This thing is 140 feet long. By all means, it's a big project. Something to consider is you could use any kind of circular form like a tire and make a smaller scaled arch. So that's a project that is not too big that you could build somewhere in a smaller space. The next thing, choosing the right stones. My first delivery was garden stone, and it's really irregular and it's really hard to stack. It would take like 2 hours just to get five rocks in. So you really want to do your research on what you could get for flat stones. This blue stone is what I really utilize the most. It's super flat and it was easy to stack, and I could really interlock them. Less grinding time as well, which is huge. Another big thing was the cobblestone. Being from New England, this is easy to get, and I recommend getting as much rectangle and square pieces as you can, because this whole first row of the arch, I utilized that as much as I could right here and all the back support. So these came really in handy because they'd go right against it. One thing to note, when you're building out your base at the bottom, you want really big rocks. So the garden rocks, the first delivery, he sent a variety. There was giant rocks in there. So I use them at the bottom base, and that holds all that weight all the way up. So you really want big rocks at the bottom. Also in your delivery, you want to think about getting six giant rocks. This is one right here, and then I have another one down at the bottom. So about 3 feet back, holding all that weight right here. And there's actually one on the other side that's like right. Camera down. And then on the back, about 3 feet in, right around here, is another one. And that is holding all this arch support, which is 1,500 pounds, but I guess that's 750 pounds held on that side. So you really want those giant boulders to hold all that weight. Another quick thing, when you get a delivery, I recommend putting down a tarp, because there's so many little pieces of stone when you're cutting, it's just chipping and flying everywhere. Random notes. This took 68 days to build, 2 months roughly, and I worked about 4 hours a day. The shade was huge, so think about that when you're thinking about a location. Also, the garden stones, it was so hard to stack those. So if one side isn't working, go to the other side. Like, this is the biggest puzzle you'll ever put together. So let's talk about stones and numbers. This actually weighs 12,500 pounds. When I actually went to the stone yard, they deliver in tons, which is 2,000 pounds. And roughly, it's about $250 for a delivery, and they'll bring 4 tons. So I drive a Subaru, and I could only pick up 700 pounds. So I would have to go 3 times or borrow my friend's truck, and I would only have to go 2 times, which was a Toyota Tacoma, which was 1,400 pounds that I would have to put in his truck, take it out, and actually do all the effort. So when you first start figuring this out, talk to them and maybe you could get a deal and you can save time and energy. So when I was working on the top of the arch, I got the keystone set in place, but all these little light holes were shining through, and I wanted to make it structurally strong. So I ended up finding slate. It was really hard to come by. I called all these roofing companies, couldn't find anything. And on Facebook Marketplace, I found someone local, and it was like 5 pieces for $10. Breaks real easy and it's super thin. So I just take a rubber mallet and just bang it in, and it made it that much stronger. So I definitely recommend getting some slate for the top. So when I got midway, I kept messing up because the degrees of the rocks weren't lining up. When I put the 30 and 60, that really helped out. Definitely check your work. That's huge. Like, just keep taking a step back every 25 minutes and really looking at what you've done, and make sure that you're aligned to where you want to be. Your tools. Angle grinder is going to be utilized the most. I recommend getting 2 of these so you don't have to take off the nut every time. This is your metal cutting wheel, so you'll be cutting all your stone with this. And then this is a diamond grinding wheel, so you'll get off any imperfections and smooth any stone out. At the beginning of the video, I was holding this. This is a blacksmith hammer. It worked amazing for this, but I recommend getting the right tool. Stone hammer will do the job. So that's about it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, leave them below in the comments and I will get back to you as quick as I can. I did so much research, so any way I can help, I'm all about it. And like this video so it gets out to more people in the world, and hopefully they get motivated to build. And take care. Enjoy over there. Later.